नमस्ते डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू अवर सोशल क्लास। ए क्वेश्चन फॉर यू, हाउ आर मेंबर्स इन ए फैमिली डिफरेंट? इन ए फैमिली द मेंबर्स विल बी डिफरेंट। सम आर यंग, सम आर ओल्ड, सम वर्क एट होम, सम गो टू ऑफिस। सिमिलरली इवन द पीपल इन ए सोसाइटी आर ऑल्सो डिफरेंट, बट स्टिल everyone is important. Today we'll learn about why everyone and how everyone are important in a society. Right students? Now we'll learn the importance of living together. Why all of us in a society, each member in a society, all of us should live together, respect each other. Because every person is important. Every person helps us in one way or other. Let us try. Okay, first farmers. Farmers work hard in the fields and they grow crops for us. Because of farmers, we are able to get good food. Can you imagine your life without food? So we have to be thankful for the farmers. We have to respect the farmers. Okay, next. People in cities make new and modern things. Yes, many things like phones, home appliances, electronic goods, many other things, right? People in city, medicines, people in city make new and modern things for the village people as well as the town people. So people who are in cities, they also make new things, modern things, so that the people in village are comfortable, and also they make things for the people who are in town also. So people in cities are also important. Farmers are very important for us because they grow food for us, they grow crops for us. People in cities are important because they make new things and modern things, so that is how they help us. Next, tribals are also important. We can't say that tribals are someone not important. Tribals are also important because they take care of forests. Okay, they take care of forests. Because of forests only we get so many things. We get so many things like wood, medicines, honey, many things from forests. So farmers are important, people in cities are important, tribals are also important. Now I have a question, students. How should a person who is working in an office treat a person who is working in a factory? Okay, how should he treat, or how should a factory worker should treat a farmer? The answer is that a person who is working in the office should treat the person who is working in the factory with respect. He should respect the factory worker, because the factory worker, they make so many things, they help to make so many modern things. And a factory worker should be thankful to the farmer and he should respect him. So we all, this is very clear, students, that in this society everyone are important, whether the farmers, whether the people in cities or the tribals. We are depending upon each other to fulfill our needs. What do we need? We are getting from farmers. Other things we are getting from factory workers and from offices. People help us, right? We are getting our income to run the family. So all the different people in a society are important for us. We have to respect each other, right students? Now for today's homework. Now for today's homework, students. Today's homework is workbook, finish S4, page number 18. Okay, open your volume to workbook to page number 18 and answer the questions. In notebook, answer practice question number 7. I repeat, workbook volume 2, finish S4 page number 18. And in notebook, answer practice question number 7. Let us discuss what are the questions in page number 18 of your workbook. Okay, this is your workbook, right? Let us see what are the questions. First question, what will happen if all people in a society start farming? society, everyone becomes farmers, what will happen? So you should write, if all the people in a society start farming, then there will be lot of food. But we also need other things like toothpaste, home appliances, TVs, fans. Who will make all these things? So there won't be all the new and modern things for us to use. So if everyone becomes farmers, that is also a problem, right? So we also need people who work in the factories. We also need people who work in the offices, right, students? The second one, B1, there are no people to work in the factories. If there are no people to work in the factories, we won't be getting new things or modern things. Okay, maybe it might be your pencil box, it might be a laptop, or it might be your school bag or books. We also need the people who work in the factories. So what will happen if there are no people to work in the factories? If there are no people to work in the factories, then the factories will get closed and you won't have any things to use, okay, at home. It will be a big problem for us. You just can't be happy with only food. We also need other comforts. So write any two sentences from this, what you have understood. From all that you have understood, write only two sentences clearly. See, when all the people start gathering food from forests. See, what happens if all the people go to the forest? Okay, we won't do farming. Okay, we won't work in the factories. We'll go to the forest. Like the tribal people will also gather the food, collect the food, collect the leaves and roots or fruits, wild foods. We'll eat and we'll sleep. What will happen? If everyone goes and collects food from the forest, then the forest will end up. The food in the forest will end up, and even the trees also cannot survive. Okay, that is one answer. Then second question, is the behavior of the people correct? What will you tell them? Why? Okay, some behavior of people is here. You have to read it and understand, and you should say whether it is right or not. Why it is not correct also, you should give the reason. Someone shouts at the sweeper sweeping the floor. Okay, so someone is sweeping the floor. And someone comes and shouts on them, hey, what are you saying? How are you sweeping? Is it so dirty? Did you have your food or not? What kind of a person you are? Waste person you are? Is it right behavior? Such kind of behavior. If someone is sweeping the floor and someone is shouting on them, is it correct behavior? What is the right behavior? The right behavior is, if we want to say anything to the sweeper, we can talk politely, okay, because he is also working, we are also working, he is also working hard and we are also working hard. We have to understand and respect each other. If sweepers are not there, then the whole city will be stinking. Everywhere garbage will be there. So each person in our area is important, whether it is milkman, cobbler or the sweeper. Everyone is important, so they should be treated with respect. Then B, someone calls the farmers working in the field dirty. Okay. So someone is saying that these farmers who are working in the field are dirty all the time. They'll be putting their legs in the mud. Okay. In the sun they'll work. Look at the clothes that they are wearing. They are dirty. If someone says that the people who are working in the farms are dirty or fields are dirty, then those people will stop working. Oh, everyone is saying that we are dirty. Why should we do this work? They'll stop growing the food. They'll stop taking care of the animals. So what will we eat? If the people stop working in the fields, who will grow crops for us? Who will grow the food for us? Who will get the milk and eggs and meat for us? So now, I hope you have understood today's lesson, that everyone in the society are important. Even in our area also, in our neighborhood also, every person is important. Whether it is a newspaper boy, whether it is a milkman, whether it is any other person, sweeper or the person who collects the garbage or a doctor or a teacher, every person is important in the society. So we should respect each other. Thank you, children. Hope you have understood the lesson well. Complete the homework. Have a nice day.